I have an update, guys. We got batteries. We got lots of them. I tried putting them in. Doesn't go in. They have sealed it up. Anyway. See what I did there? I had the tree rocking around me instead of me rocking around the tree, you know? You know what I'm saying? Good morning! Ooh, hot. How are you all doing? Wow, we are now on day 3 of Vlogmas. I feel like because I work for myself, I don't have like an unusual routine like a lot of other people do where they wake up, they go to work and they finish their day. I don't have that same structure. So I'm always trying to get that structure into my day. I'm always trying to get a routine so that I have something I can stick to. Like, it's good to have your body clock going and a rhythm to like get up in the morning and hit the ground running, you know? So this morning I went running, but I'm gonna be honest, I chickened out of the run a little bit because it was cold, so I hit the gym instead. It still counts. But I just find when I run outdoors, I go further than when I run indoors because that stop button is just too close. It's also when you're outside, you kind of lose yourself as well in the surroundings. As I'm on the treadmill, I really feel like I'm working because I'm just like in the same spot, looking at the same things. Anyway, guys, so today I'm gonna get my glam on with you. I wanted to show you how I created this look today. I've got a little Christmas party happening this evening, so I wanted to get all glammed up for that. It's probably one of my favorite festive looks, and that's why I decided to create it today. So if you've been enjoying my Vlogmas videos so far, please do hit that subscribe button if you're not already subscribed, and give this video a thumbs up if you like makeup tutorials and you'd like to see more. I also noticed that in the comments, all of you guys have been asking for makeup tutorials, so I was like, now's my time. So I'm excited to do this makeup tutorial for you guys. I'm gonna do a statement red lip and a black eyeliner flick. I think the last 6 months I've been really appreciating how powerful makeup is. Not only transforming the way you look, but also your confidence. And bring out your personality. I'm all for letting your confidence shine through, but I feel like makeup can help facilitate that. You know, it's enhancing your natural beauty, not covering it up. So yeah, that's basically what I wanted to say. Anyway, so as I was doing this, I realized my mic had died, no batteries, so quickly got some batteries. They're in there now. So I have already put on a little bit of makeup. I'm gonna show you what I did. So I prepped my body using this Soleil Blanc by Tom Ford. It's like holiday in a bottle. I'm gonna put a little bit more on now. And it came out in their summer collection, but I just love using it even now because I feel like, you know, this time of year, people are often heading to their local sunbed and people say, oh, don't go to sunbed because when you're older, you're gonna have problems. No, you're gonna have problems straight away. Sunspots can show even in young skin and they also dry the skin out so much. You can really embrace your natural skin tone just by looking after it. And you don't have to look pasty just because you're not in the sun. You can use a really good exfoliator on your skin, you can moisturize, you can use an oil, all these things that make it shine and radiate and glow from the inside out. Then I used this Wonder Glow Primer by Charlotte Tilbury. Then I followed up with my Creme de la Mer foundation that's been color matched to my skin. This one is in Linen 13. This one is absolutely dreamy on my skin. I find the color is just perfect. It's a slightly lighter color, but I don't mind that because I can add warmth to the look using my bronzer. I'd rather that than having to like desperately try and blend in a slightly darker foundation to give myself a more warmer look. Concealer that I'm using is this beautiful creamy concealer from Creme de la Mer. This one is in a shade Very Light. This color is even lighter than my foundation because I use it under the eyes and it kind of gives brightness to the eyes as well. And then any other areas I feel like need covering up, like my pimples, What I do with my, okay, on my lips, just to add a bit of moisture, I've gone for the Lano Lips. This one's my favorite, it smells of lemon sherbet. So the palette I'm using is this gorgeous palette from Charlotte Tilbury. This is the Instant Eye Palette. Has my name on it, Emma. Just so versatile, I can use it in the day and I can use the same palette for the evening because it's got all those looks combined. As a base, I use the concealer on my eyelids, but now I'm gonna go in with this beautiful light shade in Day Eye. Then I'm going to use that kind of like ombre color in Desk Eye. And this is my NARS flat brush. And I'm just gonna go in using the slightly darker one on the Desk Eye, just on the corners. For under the eye, I'm gonna use this really nice slanted brush by Tom Ford. I'm just going to go in using, again, that darker one, part of Desk Eye. I'm just gonna bring it down below the lower lash line. I also noticed that my eyes are looking a little bit dry, so I'm gonna use this eye dew. I don't use it that often, but it's good when you just wanna bring to life your tired eyes. Now that I've got the darker color on there with the flat brush, I'm gonna just blend those two together. I'm just gonna now like clean up all the fallout from the eyeshadow and get myself kind of neaten up those lines. So I go back in with my concealer. And just make sure that all of that fallout is kind of covered up. Oh, you fell off my chair. Your finger is actually quite warm and it's just some oils in your finger. So I'm just gonna use my finger just to tap that in. When I had my makeup done once by NARS, they didn't use any brushes. They used their hands for everything. It was interesting, interesting approach. I think it can work for some people. I don't think you need expensive brushes just to have makeup looking good. You just need to know how to apply it. I'm gonna do the eyebrows afterwards because I like to see how much I need, how much I want to build on the eyebrows depending on the eyes. So, I'm now gonna go in with my eyeliner. I am gonna be using for this Victoria Beckham eyeliner. Top tip for a feline flip cat eye is make sure your pencil is sharp. Buy a sharpener. It is key, guys, key. I'm not gonna do that line, I'm just gonna do it just very gently. You know what, I've changed my mind. I'm gonna double line and I'm gonna use the liquid line first. So for the liquid line, I'm gonna use my Tom Ford liquid liner. This one is in 01 Deeper. It has two ends. I'm gonna go for the slightly small one so I have a bit more precision. The best way to do it, if I didn't have to hold this mirror, would be to stretch the eye and go like that. That makes it easier for sure. But I need to hold this mirror. What I do is I just measure it from the base of the eyebrow down. I want to finish right there. Just checking how we're doing for time. We've got half an hour left. We're okay. So, also another thing I would say is be brutal with your eyeliners, with your mascaras. If they are dry, throw them away, guys. There's nothing worse than trying to like make them last a little bit longer and you're trying to like get good lashes with dry, crusty mascara or trying to make a feline flick or a cat eye when your makeup, when there's no more left in the eyeliner and it's just dry. You're gonna really struggle and it's just not gonna look good. That means putting on the lids, guys. Always make sure you put the lids back on product because it is gonna dry out otherwise and you can't make it last. On the left eye, I'm gonna try the 01 Ultra Black by Guerlain. And the reason is that I'm finding that the one by Tom Ford, I've used so much, it's getting dry, so I'm switching up. It makes it so much easier when you've got a new, fresh one. The eyeliner gives you that shape, that structure, that definition, but a pencil can really add depth of color. So I'm gonna go in and go over the line using my Victoria Beckham black eyeliner in black saffron. It's so creamy, it's so easy to glide on. I love this. Not forgetting, I usually do this first but I forgot about it, so I'm gonna do it now, is to pull up the eyelid and go underneath. So I'm gonna do that now, just figuring out a way to do it. I need a mirror here. I'm gonna go right in. That way we're covering up, making sure we've got no gaps. I'm okay, I'm still here. when you're cleaning up your eyelids and you're doing a feline flick, earbud cleaners, probably goes without saying, and you probably guys already know, but these ones are different. You can see they're much more pointy than your regular earbud cleaners, and that gives precision. And I just picked these up from Boots. Yeah, you don't have to go anywhere fancy for it. I'm just cleaning up because that eyeliner went onto the bottom lid and I don't want that. Now that we've double lined, I'm now gonna put on some lashes. See what these look like on, just to test if they're gonna look too much. Yeah, they're way too much, I think. Way too much. I would wear those for more of like a really full on glam night out, because they're a little bit long. Yeah, I'm gonna go for these ones by Huda Beauty. These ones are called Giselle. I'm going to just use my Duo Gel. This one is a black color, so it's not like a white color, which I like, because then, because white glue goes everywhere and it's really noticeable, whereas this is dark. And I wait for a couple seconds until it's tacky, because it's much easier to apply glue when it's slightly more tacky than when it's really fresh and slipping everywhere. I always like to put the mirror underneath as well, because then you're not moving your eye around. I'm just gonna let that dry. I love these lashes because they're really fluttery. They're not like really full on. Come into life. I love lashes, love a lash. You might need to bend them, just like wiggle them up a little bit, make them looser. And grab it as close to the line as possible. On this eyeliner, it's double ended. So you've got that, and then you've also got this creamy vanilla, which is great because if you put this on the waterline, it really opens up the eyes. For eyebrows, I'm gonna be using this Dolce & Gabbana eyebrow pencil. This one is in soft brown. On one end you have the pencil, and then the other one you have this. What I do is I brush up first, just so I can see the gaps. And I'm really just gonna go in with the gaps with small brush strokes. And then I brush down to see also how much is filled in. When you do this, it really makes a big difference to the eyebrow. Set my brows using my matte clear gel. Clear because I want it not to look heavy. So set them, keep them in place. So eyebrows done. Now I'm gonna put on some bronzer, some contouring, and do the lip. Bronzer, I'm gonna use my Creme de la Mer big brush with my name on it. This is Emma. Bronzer, I'm going to use this Dolce & Gabbana bronzer. Love this shade. This one is in Honey Matte. Doing the shade of the three on the temples, on that jawline, down the side of the neck. Just where the sun, if there was any, would hit. For the contour, I'm going to go in with my slanted Spacing K brush. Just in the hollows of my cheeks. That down, just by switching it like that. Take that down the sides of the nose. A bit of a contoured nose. And on the ends. For highlight, I'm gonna use Charlotte Tilbury's Magic Wand. Beautiful, it's so dreamy. Just like that. Down the nose. Just gonna blend that in. Ooh, fancy. Powder, I'm gonna use my Sigma F37 brush and my Givenchy Prism Powder. It's translucent, so it's not gonna add any color. Corner of the eye, I'm going to use this Disco Eye color. I wanna increase that gold a little bit more in the corner, so I'm gonna use Marc Jacobs eyeliner in Marigold. Now for my favorite part, I'm gonna do the lips. Just gonna neutralize the color of my lips, a little bit of remaining foundation on here. I'm gonna line them first with this lip pencil by Charlotte Tilbury in Savage Rose. Then going in with this beautiful red color. This is a retro matte liquid lip in Dance With Me. Oh yeah. One last thing I almost forgot is my Urban Decay All Nighter. Just to set the makeup and keep it in place. Just to finish off, I'm gonna put a little bit of this on my body, on my shoulders, because it gives that gorgeous glow.
just on my clavicle. It's like a highlighter, but for your body.
That's it for my festive beauty look, and I really hope you've enjoyed watching, guys. Thank you so much. If you have any other video suggestions you'd like me to do, then please let me know in the comments because I'll make them for you. I'm just gonna show you a close-up of this look. Well, the giveaway is going ahead, guys. I'm giving away these awesome prizes for you to win. This Love Your Selfie 2 palette by Pure, and it comes with 8 eyeshadows, a mascara, lip gloss, matte lip pencil, baking powder, highlighter, and bronzer all in one. And beautiful colors, perfect for winter. Going with the theme of baking, this is the Laura Geller Baking Frosting Face and Body Glow. This is so beautiful on your skin and body for giving that gorgeous glow. This is James Reed's Gradual Tan Sleep Face Mask. It's so perfect because you can leave it on overnight and just wash it off in the morning, and it gives you a really nice natural bronzed look. I'm giving away this beautiful candle. It smells divine. Those are all the prizes you can win. All the details on how to win these goodies are going to be in the description box below, so do check it out, and I wish you the best of luck. Thank you so much, guys, for watching, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye! Look at me, hot. Look at me, hot. Look at me, hot. Looking like a quarter lick. Run up on me, you get hit. And all my bitches with the shit. Yeah. Don't New York kiss a bitch. Yeah. Looking like I caught a lick. Yeah. Since they wanna. Legit fell off my chair. Trying to look all sexy.